Today we will discuss about halogenation, nitration, sulfonation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation and acylation reaction. So first of all we will discuss about the halogenation. You know that halogenation reaction in case of benzene is a reaction in which the hydrogen is replaced with the halogen, and the halogen specifically being the chlorine and the bromine. So chlorination and bromination can be two different categories in case of halogenation reaction. Generally iodination and fluorination cannot be done because of the reactivity factors, that fluorine itself is highly reactive. And if we are talking about iodination, because iodine is not highly reactive, it is too unreactive. So iodination and fluorination cannot be done by using these simple reagents, but chlorination and bromination can be done, in which the hydrogen of the benzene is replaced with the chlorine and the bromination. So collectively these two reactions will be come under the category halogenation reaction, and this particular halogenation reaction will come under the category aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. Mechanism is again a typical aromatic electrophilic substitution mechanism, in which the electrophile will be generated. And you know, electrophile will be this halonium ion, right? This, if we are particularly talking about this halonium ion X positive, that will be your electrophile. So in case of bromination, it will be the Br positive, and in case of chlorination, it will be the Cl positive. That will be the electrophile for the reaction. So the electrophile will be generated, and which reagent will generate the electrophile? That will be the Lewis acid. So we generally use the benzene ring, and benzene ring will react with X2 in presence of AlX3 or FeX3. So for example, we are talking about the bromination. So this reaction can be done by using the benzene and bromine in presence of FeBr3, right? So basically the role of this Lewis acid FeBr3 here is to polarize the halogen bond, is to polarize the ClCl bond, or is to polarize the BrBr bond, so that Br positive or Cl positive can be easily generated out, so that reaction can happen, right? So this is the overall reaction. And what will be the mechanism of this particular reaction? That is, in the first step, this particular bromine will be generated, and this, you know, Br first of all react with the Lewis acid, and Br positive and FeBr3 negative, this particular complex will be synthesized, and now this benzene ring will react with this bromine, and then this rhenium ion will be synthesized, which finally in the next step will lose the H positive, and it will get converted into bromobenzene, right? So bromobenzene can be prepared, or chlorobenzene can be prepared, by using halogenation reaction. Here are the application of this halogenation reaction, that where we can use it, halogenation reaction, if I am particularly talking about. So here are some biologically active aryl chlorides which can be used for different applications worldwide. For example, this is, its generic name is bupro and trade name is Jiban, and this can be act as the antidepressant, right? And this particular aryl chloride is also used as nicotine, reduce the nicotine cravings. Here are some more aryl chlorides. For example, this one, which act as the antihistamine agent. Here is another, and this is another, right? This will act as the herbicide, and this again act as the herbicides, right? So these herbicides, as you can see in this picture, they were used during the Vietnam War, right? So this is the synthetic application of this halogenation reaction, that they can be used in forming different type of the aryl chlorides which can be having different kind of the properties. They can be used as a herbicides, they can be used as an antidepressant, they can be used for antihistamine reagents, etc., etc. So this is the significance of the halogenation reaction. This is the energy profile diagram for the same reaction, that is bromination. So this is you have the similar step, you have the similar mechanism for this particular reaction. The reaction will be a two-step mechanism, so in which transition state 1 will be synthesized, and this is the rate determining step, and then second will be the first step, and this will be the intermediate, that is the arrhenium ion, that for the particular reaction. Now we will come to the nitration reaction. When we are talking about the nitration reaction, in nitration reaction generally the H positive of the benzene will be replaced by the electrophile NO2 positive. And how this NO2 positive can be generated? This can be generated either by treatment of the fuming nitric acid, or we can take the nitric acid and sulfuric acid complex. We can also take N2O5, that can also be taken, right? So nitration can be done by taking the benzene and nitratic mixture, means a mixture of HNO3 and sulfuric acid, or only fuming nitric acid, or N2O5 may also be taken, right? So they will replace the H positive with NO2 positive. So basically here, if we are particularly talking about this reaction, the role of this H2SO4 is to generate the NO2 positive, that is the nitronium ion, right? And this generation of nitronium ion as an electrophile requires a very strong acid. So generally sulfuric acid is being taken along with the nitric acid. And what will be the role of the sulfuric acid? The role of this sulfuric acid is to protonate the HNO3 so that it can easily leave the H2O and can generate NO2 positive. So this NO2 positive will be generated, and in the next step the benzene will react with this NO2 positive, forming the arrhenium ion, which finally will get converted into nitrobenzene. So this reaction is also synthetically very much important, because this is the path by which the nitrogen can be attached to the benzene ring. Nitro group can be attached, they can further be reduced, then they can be converted into diazonium salt, and different type of the products can be synthesized by using this particular nitrobenzene. So this is a route by which we can incorporate NO2 group into the benzene system. So synthetically this reaction is also very much important. Again, if we are particularly talking about the energy profile diagram for this nitration reaction, again it will be just similar to that of the halogenation reaction, right? In which there will be two transition state, that is transition state number 1 and 2. Again, the first step will be the rate determining step, and the second step will be a fast step, and there will be formation of an intermediate, that will be the arrhenium ion. Now come to the sulfonation. If we are particularly talking about sulfonation reaction, it can be done by taking the oleum. And oleum is a mixture of SO3, sulfur trioxide, and sulfuric acid. Remember one thing, that sulfonation reaction is irreversible reaction, right? It is a reversible reaction if you are particularly talking about the sulfonation one, right? So the importance of this reaction is that by using this reaction we can replace the hydrogens in benzene with the deuterium. So this is the synthetic importance of this particular reaction, sulfonation. It is used to replace the hydrogen of the benzene ring with the deuterium. This reaction is a reversible reaction. So to get the product benzene sulfonic acid, what we will have to do is to remove the water molecule as soon as possible they are synthesized. as the water molecule are being synthesized during the course of reaction, they will be replaced, right? So replacing the water molecule will make this reaction more effective. Now, what will happen here? We are getting two molecules of the sulfuric acid, and they will react to generate the electrophile. And electrophile is SO3 H positive, in which this benzene ring will react with the sulfur, and then finally it will lose the H positive and will get converted into benzene sulfonic acid. Right? So this is the importance of this reaction. I have already told you about the importance of the reaction. So synthetically, this reaction is also very much important, because in many of the cases, we, when studied about the evidences of any mechanism, we generally use isotopic tracer effects, isotopic labeling effect we generally studied. So here, hydrogen will be replaced with the deuterium. So that particular substrate can be used for other different type of evidences for the mechanism, right? So that was sulfuration reaction. Now come to the next reaction. This is Friedel-Crafts reaction. So Friedel-Crafts reaction are divided into two categories, and these are alkylation and acylation reaction. So first of all, we will discuss about the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, in which we generally use alkyl halide in presence of Lewis acid. And the Lewis acid which is being used here in alkylation reaction is usually AlCl3. This Lewis acid is used to generate the electrophile, and the electrophile here in this reaction is the carbocation. Now, because a reaction can be done by using primary, secondary or tertiary alkyl halides, so what will be the difference in the mechanism? That the mechanism, you know, is basically a two-step mechanism, in which in the first step the benzene ring will react with the electrophile, and in the second step the hydrogen will be eliminated in the form of H positive and the aromatization will happen. But when we are talking about the generation of the electrophile, as we know that the carbocation will be the electrophile in case of Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, so we are using Lewis acid as a catalyst here. In case of primary alkyl halide, the carbocation will not be generated particularly, means Lewis acid base complex will be acting as the electrophile in case of primary alkyl halide, if I am particularly talking about, right? And if I am talking about secondary and tertiary alkyl halide, at that time you will get the free carbocation because they are stable. So this is the difference into the generation of the electrophile mechanism. For example, this one is a case of primary alkyl halide when it react with AlCl3. First of all, this is the Lewis acid base complex, in which this particular chlorine will attach with this particular aluminium and it will acquire some positive charge. So it will withdraw the electron from this particular carbon. So this carbon will be electron deficient now. So now this benzene will attack on this particular carbon which is electron deficient. So this is for the primary alkyl halides, and this one for the tertiary alkyl halide, in which tertiary carbocation is being synthesized because it is more stable. So it will be synthesized in this case, right? So this is your tertiary alkyl halide. Now this again react with this one, and finally protonation will happen, and you will get this particular product. So this is the difference of the alkyl halides if we have taken the primary, secondary and tertiary. Now, if I am talking about the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, it has many disadvantages. there are many limitations of this particular Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. And what are those limitations? What are those disadvantages? We must be knowing about that. The first one is, as we know, that carbocation formation will be there, and carbocation, you also know that the rearrangements are very common in case of carbocation. So there will be either hydride shift or alkyl shift will happen, and most stable carbocation will get synthesized. So the limitation is, rearrangements are very common in case of Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, and the example is given here. We have taken this particular alkyl halide. So it was posed that the attachment of this carbon will happen with this benzene, means a state 3 carbon chain will be attached with the benzene ring. But what is our product? Our product was not that we expected, but this is unexpected product. This is the rearranged product of the reaction, means that will depend upon the stabler carbocation. So from here, primary carbocation will be generated, and this can be shifted. Hydride shift can happen, 1-2 hydride shift will happen, and secondary carbocation will be generated. So that will react with this benzene ring, and this product will be synthesized in case of this particular reaction. So this is the first limitation of the reaction. The second limitation is that when R group is introduced on the benzene ring, as we know that R group is strongly activating group, it will activate the ring. When it activate the ring by plus I effect, it means that it will further initiate the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. So polysubstitution is generally observed in case of Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. For example, this is the case in which this particular alcohol in presence of BF3 is reacting with this benzene. This can also be used as the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reagent. We can not only take the alkyl halide in presence of AlCl3, we can also take alkenes in presence of H positive, we can also take alcohols in presence of sulfuric acid or BF3, right? So the alkyl halides in presence of AlCl3 is not only the alkylating reagent, but alkenes in presence of acid and alcohols in presence of acid are also the Friedel-Crafts alkylating reagents. So here, if we are particularly talking about this reaction, this is the monosubstitution product, and this will activate the ring further for the reaction to happen. Now this again activate this para position, and now we are getting this product. So this product will also be synthesized, and this product will also be synthesized. So generally we get polysubstituted product in case of Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Next one is, if we are particularly taking vinyl halides and aryl halides as the alkylating reagent, at that time there will be no reaction, because aryl cations and vinyl cations cannot be generated. So if they are not generated, it means there will be no reaction at that time. So this is again the third limitation of the Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. The next one is, if electron withdrawing groups are attached with the benzene ring, at that time the yield will be very, very less, right? In presence of electron withdrawing groups, the yield is very poor. This is fourth limitation of Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. Here are some examples in which the benzene is containing electron withdrawing groups, right? Here is the other sources by which you can produce the carbocations. For example, alkenes can be used, alcohols can be used. I have already told you about it. So these are some common alkylating agents by which we can use as a reagent in Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction. So that's all about alkylation. In tomorrow's class, we will discuss about acylation and some more important aspects of aromatic lactophilic substitution reaction.